Sure, Neptune is cold, but not as much as Uranus. If intelligent beings from outside the solar system were to observe Neptune and Uranus, they might be prone to think that these are twin planets. And they wouldn't be completely wrong. These two share almost identical physical characteristics, especially now that we know Neptune is not actually as blue as we have been picturing it over the last few decades, but is in fact the same color as Uranus. However, upon closer inspection, perhaps one provided by our point of view from Earth, the two celestial objects present remarkable differences. Above all, they have different temperatures. This wouldn't be surprising, given that if you consider the Sun as a huge source of heat, the farther you move from it, the colder it gets. Following this reasoning, Neptune would be the coldest among the two, being the farthest. However, Uranus defies this law. It is indeed much colder than Neptune. How is this possible? Let's find out. Similar planets, different planets. Neptune, residing as the eighth and farthest planet from the Sun, boasts a diameter of approximately 30,598 miles, or 49,244 kilometers, making it the fourth largest planet. Its atmosphere, primarily composed of hydrogen and helium, exhibits a dynamic interplay of weather patterns, including the presence of the Great Dark Spot, akin to Jupiter's Great Red Spot. Winds on Neptune surge at speeds of up to 1,200 miles per hour, or 1,930 kilometers per hour, contributing to its turbulent yet mesmerizing atmosphere. Contrastingly, Uranus, the seventh planet, revolves at an average distance of about 1.8 billion miles, or 2.9 billion kilometers, possessing a diameter of roughly 31,518 miles, or 50,724 kilometers. Slightly larger than Neptune. The atmosphere of Uranus, also dominated by hydrogen and helium, is characterized by a unique hood, a layer of warm air above its cloud tops. Winds, though not as intense as Neptune's, reach speeds of about 560 miles per hour or 900 kilometers per hour. Both planets exhibit a distinct color palette resulting from the presence of methane in their atmospheres. Recent observations have unveiled that Neptune shares the same blue hue as Uranus, dispelling the obvious notion of its exclusive coloration. We made a video covering the topic. Why don't you check it out? In terms of their orbital characteristics, Neptune completes a single orbit around the Sun in approximately 165 Earth years, while Uranus, with a shorter orbital period, takes about 84 Earth years for its journey around the solar system. Voyager 2, the lone spacecraft to adventure to these distant realms, unveiled a wealth of information during its flybys in 1986 of Uranus and 1989 of Neptune. These revelations, from magnetic field anomalies to atmospheric dynamics, continue to inspire further exploration and deepen our understanding of why such apparently similar planets are in fact so much different. Having briefly described the two planets, we can now gain a better understanding of why Uranus is colder than Neptune. There may be more than one reason. The atmospheric factor. While the distance from the Sun is a critical factor in determining the temperatures of the planets, the atmosphere likely plays an even more significant role. Visualize the atmosphere as a lid, and the planet as something you wish to cook. Using a minimal external heat source, you warm up your food. Now consider the lid in place, but with holes. The vapor emitted as your food cooks will gently waft through the kitchen, leaving an enticing aroma. The energy stored in the vapor will heat up the house. Conversely, if the lid lacks holes, the vapor molecules would carry energy, remaining close and warming your food. In essence, a transparent lid results in a lower temperature underneath compared to a completely solid and smooth lid. Similarly, a planet with a dense atmosphere can effectively trap the heat from the Sun, preventing it from escaping into space. This phenomenon is exemplified on the scorching planet Venus. The consistently high temperatures on Venus result from its thick atmosphere, creating a persistent greenhouse effect that keeps the surface temperature consistently above 896 degrees Fahrenheit or 480 degrees Celsius. As for Uranus, the atmosphere also helps us understand why it is colder than Neptune. This planet indeed possesses the coldest atmosphere in our solar system. Its composition primarily consists of hydrogen, about 82.5%, helium, 15.2%, and a small percentage of methane, approximately 2.3%. This methane content plays a crucial role in shaping the distinct appearance of Uranus. The estimated temperature of Uranus's atmosphere is exceptionally frigid, with temperatures plunging to around minus 371 degrees Fahrenheit or minus 224 degrees Celsius. You may ask, how do astronomers measure Uranus's temperature? Well, estimates are largely derived from various observations and analyses, particularly through telescopic observations from Earth and data gathered by the Voyager 2 spacecraft during its flyby in 1986. By studying the thermal radiation emitted by Uranus and analyzing the composition of its atmosphere, scientists can infer the temperature gradients and gain insights into the unique climatic conditions of this distant ice giant. As you can see, data collected by Voyager 2 continues to be a valuable resource for refining our understanding of Uranus and its enigmatic atmosphere. Later on in the video, I will tell you what this probe discovered about Uranus's clouds. Before discussing that, however, there's something more you need to know. The internal heat. Not only is the surface temperature low, but Uranus is also cold on the inside. Unlike some other planets, it does not emit significant internal heat, making it challenging to precisely gauge its interior temperature. However, scientists use theoretical models and indirect observations to infer information about the planet's internal conditions. The estimated internal temperature of Uranus is thought to be influenced by its formation and subsequent evolution. The planet likely formed through the gradual accretion of solid materials and gases in the early solar system. During this process, heat was generated through the conversion of gravitational potential energy into thermal energy. As Uranus evolved, the heat generated during its formation, along with heat from the Sun, contributed to its internal temperature. The planet is believed to have a layered structure consisting of a rocky core surrounded by an icy and metallic hydrogen mantle. The precise temperature distribution within these layers remains uncertain. One way scientists try to explain this extremely unusually low internal temperature is that when Uranus was hit by the object that caused the planet to tilt, putting it into the position it is found today, the collision caused the planet to lose the original and primordial internal heat that it had. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve it for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. More about Uranus. As I mentioned before, Voyager discovered something unusual within Uranus's atmosphere. More precisely, it found something amiss with the planet's clouds. When it flew by, Voyager can only spot 10 different types of clouds floating around on Uranus. This is an incredibly low number, considering that clouds typically come in a wide variety. The explanation for this strange behavior probably lies in the planet's low temperature. Such low temperatures prevent the formation of numerous mixtures of gases at different temperatures. This is profoundly different from what happens on other planets in the solar system. Take, for instance, Jupiter or Saturn. On those planets, the layers have different densities, and when they come together, they form amazing clouds, each distinct from the others. More about Neptune. As for Neptune, its atmosphere boasts a blend primarily comprising hydrogen, about 80%, helium, around 19%, and a trace of methane, approximately 1.5%. This methane content imparts a captivating blue hue to Neptune's atmosphere, setting it apart from its planetary counterpart. The atmospheric dynamics on Neptune are marked by tumultuous weather patterns, featuring the fastest winds in the solar system, reaching speeds of up to 1,500 miles per hour, or 2,414 kilometers per hour. Prominent storm systems, including the Great Dark Spot, akin to Jupiter's Great Red Spot, further characterize Neptune's dynamic and active atmosphere. Despite its greater distance from the Sun compared to Uranus, Neptune exhibits a slightly higher internal temperature, because, well, it's more active. Neptune's diverse system of moons adds another layer of distinction. Triton, its most notable moon, follows a retrograde orbit, unique among large moons in the solar system, and provides additional intrigue to Neptune's celestial ensemble. While Neptune possesses a faint system of rings, they differ from the more prominent and well-known rings of Saturn. Composed of small particles, Neptune's rings contribute to our understanding of the planet's broader environmental dynamics. In essence, Neptune emerges as a celestial counterpart to Uranus, distinguished by its vibrant blue atmosphere, dynamic weather phenomena, and unique orbital and moon characteristics. Don't get me wrong, both of these places are deadly for humans. However, if one had to make a choice, one would probably choose Neptune. The axial tilt factor. As you can understand, the main contribution to the temperature of these two planets directly comes from their atmospheres. But what about other factors? Well, it turns out the tilt of a planet's axis might influence its temperature. Let's see what implications this has on the two planets. Uranus is the only planet whose axis is inclined at almost 90 degrees with respect to the Sun's rotating plane. As you might recall, the tilt of a planet directly affects seasons and how long they last. As Uranus orbits the Sun, different hemispheres receive varying amounts of sunlight, leading to distinct seasons. Each pole of Uranus experiences about 21 years of continuous sunlight, followed by 21 years of darkness during its orbit. During the summer and winter solstices on this planet, one hemisphere faces the Sun directly, experiencing an extended day, while the other hemisphere faces away, plunging into a prolonged night. The equatorial region, on the other hand, experiences more moderate variations in sunlight and temperature throughout Uranus's year. Neptune, unlike Uranus, experiences seasonal changes, but its axial tilt is not as extreme. With a tilt of only 28.3 degrees, this planet experiences seasons in a manner more akin to those on Earth. Neptune's orbit around the Sun takes about 165 Earth years, and a day on Neptune lasts about 16 hours. As Neptune orbits the Sun, the planet's axial tilt results in various levels of sunlight exposure to its different hemispheres during different times of the year. The seasonal changes on Neptune are subtle compared to the more dramatic and prolonged seasons on Uranus. Winter on Uranus is extremely cold. No sunlight whatsoever hits the planet during the cold season. On the other hand, the tilt of Neptune's axis allows for a more evenly distributed distribution of sunlight between its hemispheres throughout its orbital period. A different solar system. As we briefly mentioned earlier, the extreme axial tilt of Uranus, where the planet essentially rotates on its side, is believed to have resulted from a significant impact from a massive object early in the solar system's history. This catastrophic collision likely occurred when Uranus was still in the process of forming, during a period known as the Late Heavy Bombardment. The impact with a celestial body, possibly a planetesimal or other large object, was so forceful that it not only caused Uranus to tilt on its side, but also led to the planet's distinctive retrograde rotation, meaning it rotates in the opposite direction to its orbital motion around the Sun. I ponder how much more similar Neptune and Uranus might be today if the collision had never occurred. The absence of such an event could have potentially shaped a vastly different solar system from the one we observe today. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. What would you like to see next? Let us know in the comments below. We'll see you next time on the channel.